Hi, Eric Gibault, ericgibault.com, and today we're speaking about, well, I see many people that say, oh, photography is art, I do art, and look at my picture, which is really artistic, all this. And what I would say is, what I'm going to speak about is, first, forget about art. Concentrate in making good pictures. Let's start. I think it's just crazy when we hear people just all speaking about art when actually what they do is not necessarily art, and very often they don't actually need things to be art. I mean, if you make a picture of your kid's birthday there with a friend, does it really need to be artistic? Not really, no. I think what it needs is to be a good souvenir, and that's it. So we're going to make a parallel with writing and reading. When you learned how to read and write, first you started with letters, then words, writing and reading. And then when you actually dominated the technique of writing and reading, this taught you about spelling, about grammar, and in your language, but maybe later in other languages. But then you were developing your knowledge about writing and reading. And then at the same time, they made you practice small text, longer text, some essay, and then some really longer philosophy essay and things like this. So you developed a technique, a knowledge about writing and reading. When you have the base, then you had two ways to go, the practical one and the literature one. The practical one could be the list you use to go shopping, your shopping list. And the literature one could be writing a novel. So there are different ways. Can we say a shopping list is literature? Not really. Can we say a novel is like a shopping list? Not really either. But if we look at the shopping list, some people just write it all the way on a small paper, it's all scrapped and it's ugly. A bit what I do. Well, I don't even write shopping lists. I actually go to the supermarket and pick what I see and think it may be useful or I may need it, and then I forget to buy many things. But really, some people write like this, the shopping list. But some other people, they really have an incredible shopping list. This is really organized. Then they have color codes, so when it's in green, I should buy it at the last. This is the thing I should buy last because they are frozen products and I don't want them to be such a long time out of a freezer. So I buy it at the last minute in the supermarket, or the other way around. This is it's chocolate, so it may melt, so I buy it at the last minute also. So I put different color code, so they organize in the small trolley, so they actually put the product in a way that they will put it in bag, so when they go home it's easier to put it in the closet. But it's really organized. So you would think, yeah, but what's the point of doing a shopping list like this if I want to do literature? Yeah, but if you want to write a novel, you have to write parts, chapter, paragraph. You need to be organized. So maybe someone who is able to write a beautiful, practical shopping list is probably prepared to write a novel in a proper way. This doesn't mean he will have the right idea, some interesting content or story. Doesn't mean this, but he will be prepared to write in a proper order his idea, his story. So it's very useful to be able to write a proper shopping list, even if your idea is to write about novel. So it's actually, there is a tuition order. You don't just starting writing a novel. There is a lot of years of learning writing and spelling and grammar and all this to be able to write a novel. And organization is one of them also. So it's important you see this point. When we speak about photography, photography is art. But it does not mean that every photo is art. Why? Because maybe it doesn't pretend to be. Doesn't need to be. If I make a picture of a screw to put on a catalog for mechanics, doesn't need to be art, doesn't need to be to transmit anything. It's just a picture that reflects a reference number in the catalog. So when I hear people say, no, photography needs to tell a story, photography needs to give emotion, it depends what kind of photography we're speaking about. It's not that simple, and that it's not always like this. So let's forget for a second about art, and let's go to photography tuition and knowledge. Well, first, the first step is to learn to see, to read light. Where is light coming from? How powerful is it? What color has it? All this. Then at the same time, you must learn how to write light with your camera. So you need to, at the same time also, because many things are at the same time, to learn to know your camera, how does it work, but also all the rest that goes with it. My lenses, tripod, lighting material, reflectors, flashes, computer, because if I work in a digital camera, I will need some computer, how not to use it, all that. You know, you need to learn all this together. And then you also need to learn techniques and rules, composition, framing, lighting. All this you need to learn, because they are the base. You need to know all this. So when you know all this, you can actually develop your own vision. I see this guy is doing this, but I see it the other way. And then develop your way of writing your vision, which is developing your own style. But first you need to know all the techniques. Actually, a good photographer, a really good photographer, is a person that is able to think of photography and make it exactly the way he thought about it. A very, very, very good photographer, a universal photographer, it does not exist because they're all specialized in something, is a photographer that a client comes and says, I need a picture this way, and he's able to do it. You've never done sport photography, but I need a picture of a sport event. Yeah, I can do it. He can do it. You've never done submarine photography, but you know how light will work, you're able to do it. And these photographers that do not exist, because we always learn during all our life. I mean, people who think that they know photography, no, we never know photography. We keep learning always. We know many things. As many years pass, we know more things, but we never know everything. So we keep learning always. So the incredible photographer is the one who is able to learn so quick that the client doesn't even see, didn't know before he started. Okay, so really, we can pretend to be good photographer when we are able to manage several styles, even if this is not a style we like. Several techniques, even if this is not our favorite technique, is a person you must be able to receive order from someone and to be able to give the results. And this is when you can feel you start to be a good photographer. So once you get to this level, then you can start thinking about art. Because then you can concentrate in art, in artistic thing. You can concentrate in transmitting. You can concentrate on emotion. But first, to concentrate on all this, you need to have all the technique. You need to have all this technique, this knowledge, and you don't get it from day one. It's not, you just got your camera today and you say, I'm doing art. No, you're not doing art. You would like to do art. One day maybe you will do art, but first there is a long way of learning. There's a long learning curve, and it's not easy. It takes time, and only experience will get you to the level of art. And you will never be able to say you're an artist. This only other people can say that about you. When they look at your picture, if it transmits something to them, if they feel there's some emotion, something, then they will tell you are an artist. You are not a photographer. Because telling it that yourself is a complete lack of humility. Honestly, we need to be humble. We're a photographer, that's it. That some people see our work as art, fine, but we cannot say this is art. This is a good picture. You see it as art, I'm really happy about it. You don't see it as art. Okay, I'm fine with it. But you cannot say it's a bad picture because look, you cannot value the technique, you can value everything what's in there, and it's hard to say this is a bad picture. The goal we should all have is make good pictures. That's our first goal. Forget about arts. I see many people, when they start, they make any kind of picture, then they go to a computer and then they put some filter on it. And they just say, well, this is art. Thinking that editing a picture is making of any picture something artistic is as stupid or irrelevant as thinking that the spelling checker of your computer or your smartphone will take any text or the shopping list and make it a novel. Obviously not. If a novel is not written properly, if the story is boring, if it's wrong structured, your spell checker will make it properly spelled. And that's it. It will not make it more interesting, will not make it a better story, it won't make it passionate, nothing. It won't work. It will just make a proper spelled novel. That's it. A bad novel, properly spelled. And that's it. And editing picture is the same thing. If your picture is bad, editing it won't make it better. Edition is the final touch, the same as the spell checker is the final touch. So this final touch will help you give life to your idea. Some people say, yeah, but since Photoshop appeared, photography is not what it was. Yeah, but they said that thinking that pictures were never edited. And that's not true. If you look at Ansel Adams, his picture before and after editing in laboratory, analog laboratory with chemicals, they're very different. Why? Because editing is not a problem when you do it as part as a process, and from the start you think what you want to do to give this final image. So that's not a problem that you did in Photoshop or you did in a laboratory is irrelevant. It's not a problem. The problem is when you think that the first step is the edition. The final edition is the first step. No, the first step is making the right picture. And to make a good picture, the first step is to learn and to know how to do it. Then you get the proper ingredients to have the base to work on it, editing it, not the other way around. My conclusion, please concentrate on making good pictures and learning. Forget about art for the time being. Once you will dominate everything, then you will be able to think about art, try to make art, and people will value if this is art. Well, thank you for watching the video. If you think it may help anyone, please share it on social networks. If you have not done yet, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. The small button down here, small bell, if you click on it, you will receive a notification when I upload a new video. My website, ericgibaud.com. If you have any question, you can leave a comment or send me an email to info@ericgibaud.com. Below, I also put links of my gear on Amazon and also links to other parts of my YouTube channel. Thank you very much. Bye.